For those of you tuning in, my name is Alex Nast, and I am going to be teaching what our rec center refers to as fusion. So fusion is usually a class that incorporates a lot of yoga, but we'll also put in a little bit of Pilates and a strong emphasis on core. Sometimes we add in things that you wouldn't typically see in a yoga or a Pilates class, but today I'm going to keep it pretty yoga oriented. For today, all you'll need is a mat, towel, rug, wherever you feel comfortable. And if you have some blocks, fabulous. If you don't, then get creative. Use some toilet paper rolls, tissue boxes, pillows, whatever works for you. You don't have to have blocks. I just like to have them nearby because you never know when you're going to want to use them. And keep in mind that they are a tool. They're not something because you're not good at something. You're going to see that there's poses that I can get in deeper than you, and vice versa. You might be able to get a lot deeper into poses than I can, and that's okay. Yoga isn't about being perfect. It's about honoring what your body can do, and it's about accepting and appreciating what your body has to offer. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and get started. We're going to start in just a child's pose. So all you're going to do is shift your hips back towards your heels. Nestle that chest into your thighs. Arms are just relaxed, extended overhead. Go ahead and rest your forehead on the floor if that feels comfortable. You can also place a blanket or a block right underneath your head. And we're just gonna start with some big deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. Using your breath to quiet your mind. Starting to oxygenate the blood. I'm giggling because I know I said that wrong, but we're just gonna go for it. It's not about being perfect. If you start to feel lost at any point in class, just back to this breath. One more big inhale. Big exhale. And walk your hands to the right. Keeping that chest down low. Lengthening through your side body. Keeping your breath calm. Walking your hands to the left. Back to the center. And sit back a little bit further. Take your knees a little bit wider. Let that chest fall between your thighs. Reach your fingertips away from you. Pull your shoulders away from your ears. Draw your shoulder blades together. Feeling your back become nice and strong. Coming up onto your hands and your knees, finding a nice tabletop position. So you want a nice flat back. Those hips are directly over your knees. Your knees are hip width apart. Your hands are right underneath your shoulders. Spread your fingers nice and wide, making big starfish hands. Around your spine to the ceiling for cat. Draw awareness to the space between your shoulder blades and breathe into that area as you try to press your spine towards the ceiling, grounding your hands into the floor. Navel is drawn in, tummy is hugging the spine, round down and look up, finding cow, making a big smiley face with your spine, opening your chest, drawing your collarbone apart, alternate between the two, finding your breath. Thank you. draw your navel in so you have no curve in your low back. Think about having your water bottle resting on your back and you don't want it to roll off. Keeping that same imagery in mind with the water bottle on your back, I want you to extend your right leg behind you. Flex your foot so that your toes are pointed towards the floor and your heel is reaching behind you. Keeping your navel drawn in so that low back stays nice and flat. Squeeze your muscles into your bones, pulling your kneecap up into your thigh. Release down, other side. If you're hearing some crackle and pop, that's good. And release down. This time as you extend the right leg, extend the left arm. Point your toes, reach with your fingers. Try to create as much space between your fingers and your toes as you can. Lengthening through the center of the body. Now I'm going to give you a little balance challenge. Take that left arm out to the side, coming straight up from the shoulder, and bring your right leg out. Back to center. Return the right left hand to the floor. Right leg comes across to the left. So your toes are rested on the left side of your body. Lengthen through your side. Try to bring your right hip away from your left. Bringing your weight onto your left knee. Left hand, right hand reaches up. Notice my right leg's coming more in line with my left knee. Reach those fingertips to the ceiling. Try to pull your ribs up towards the ceiling. Reach the right arm towards the front of your mat. Lifting back up and coming back to table. Extend the left leg and the right arm. Leg shouldn't come higher than your hip. Keeping that navel drawn in so your core is engaged. Bring the right arm out to the side and the left leg out to the left. Back to center. Return your hand to the floor and bring the left toes over. Coming onto that right knee, right hand. Reach the left arm to the side. Line your shoulders up the best you can. Lift your chest. Left arm reaches for the front of your mat. Lifting back up and back to table. Tucking your toes under, take your hips to the ceiling. Sink through your heels as your tailbone lifts towards the sky. It's more important here to maintain a flat back than having straight legs. So if you need to put a small bend in your knees to keep that back long, then please do so. As you lift the tailbone to the sky, try and press your hands away from you. Imagine your mat being made of elastic and you're trying to spread the ends away from each other, keeping your navel drawn in. Go ahead and bend one knee, sink the opposite heel, other side. Alternate side to side, nice and slow. Use your breath. Rising up on both sets of toes. Sink through both heels. Lift that tailbone a little higher. Draw your navel in a little bit stronger. Right leg sweeps up. Reach as high as you can with that leg. Bend your knee and let your heel fall towards the left hip, letting your hips open up towards the right. Gently pressing that knee back. Bringing your right leg all the way through into a low lunge. Your foot lands about between your hands. Nice long spine here, so you should have a straight line from the crown of your head to your heel. Now this time I want you to pretend like your mat is a spring and you're trying to bring the ends of your spring together. Drawing that right heel towards those back toes, drawing in towards the center of your body. Your hands are just here as balance points. This is a great spot to use some blocks if you need to. Go ahead and settle that back knee down. Let your hips fall forward slightly. Lift your chest. Big inhale and arms are just sweep up. Reach for the ceiling. Open your heart to the sky. Throw those shoulder blades back and down as if you're trying to throw them into your back pockets. Feeling the front of the left thigh opening up. Bring your hands behind you. Interlace your fingers. Draw your chest through, squeezing your shoulder blades, and gently lean back, lifting your heart a little bit higher. Release your hands, inhale, lengthen up, and exhale, fold back down towards your mat. Inhale as you look forward with that long spine. Exhale, shift your hips back and let these front toes float off the floor. Inhale, forward, looking up, long spine. Exhale, lengthen back. Two more. Back to that low lunge with the back knee lifted. Step back into your downward dog. Take a moment right here to notice the difference between each side. It might be significant, it might be very subtle, and you might not even see anything at all, and that's okay. I just want you to draw some awareness to how your body's feeling right now in this moment. Extend the left leg up towards the ceiling, point your toes, reach as high as you can. Bend your knee, let your heel fall towards your opposite hip. Let those hips open towards the left. Bring your left foot all the way through to that low lunge. My nose was not running till literally 10 minutes ago. This is ridiculous. It's allergies, I swear. All right, as if your mat was a spring, draw the ends of your spring together. Hands are just there for balance points. They're nice and light. Go ahead and settle the back knee down. Bring your weight forward into that thigh. Your back toes can stay tucked or that foot can be flat on the floor. Whatever works best for you. Inhale those arms up. Reach tall, set those shoulder blades. Bring your hands behind you. Interlace your fingers, chest through. Lean back slightly if it doesn't bother. Reaching back up. Exhale, fold. Inhale as you look forward, exhale as you come back. Inhale forward, exhale back. Two more. Last one. Coming back to your low lunge, lift your back knee off the floor and step back to your downward dog. Take a moment to notice the symmetry throughout both sides. Sink both heels towards the mat, lift that tailbone. Notice if there's a difference between the distance between your heels and the mat. There may be, there may not be, either is just fine. Walk your feet in towards your hands. Finding a forward fold. That chest just nestles into your thighs. Crown of your head becomes heavy. Never locking out the knees, keeping those knees soft. interlacing your arms by grabbing your elbows and just gently sway side to side. Feel your spine unravel. Feel some space in your neck. Or a block, you can always bring the floor to you with a block. Rolling up nice and slow, stack your spine one vertebrae at a time. And roll your shoulders up, back, and down. Reaching your fingertips towards the floor. Chest is lifted. Shoulder blades are drawn together. Take a moment to ground through your feet. Spread your toes nice and wide. Set them down one at a time, starting at the pinky toe. One side's always easier than the other. Use your inhale to lift you higher to the sun. And your exhale to ground more deeply into the earth. Two more big breaths. Drawing some awareness to how your body's feeling. Inhale, arms are going to sweep up. Exhale, forward fold. Arms go wide. Lead with your chest. Hands find your shins. Roll your shoulders up, back, and down so your back is flat. Half lift to the knees. Strong core. Draw your navel in. Release down. Hands find the floor. Step back into a plank. Twist your hands into the mat. Reach back with your heels, squeeze your glutes. You can always set your knees down if you need to. Keeping your hands twisted into the mat, start to lower your upper body towards the floor, hovering just an inch or two above. Release all the way down. Tops of your feet find the mat. Using your back to lift, shoulders out of the ears, low cobra. Release down. Tuck your toes. Twist your hands into the mat. Squeeze your elbows into your sides and push up and back to a downward dog. Step in right and left. Forward fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive. Exhale, sink to chair, sit back. Now make a big basketball hoop with your arms and hollow out your tummy. So you got this curve in your low back. I want you to make it nice and flat. Hollow out your tummy. Should feel really good on your spine. Arms are going to sweep down and back. Lift, inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. We're going to go through that again. Half lift. Exhale, release. Step back, right and left. Bending your elbows, chaturanga. Up dog, or you can stay with that low cobra. Down dog. Step in, right and left. Reverse swan dive, sink to chair, make that basketball hoop round through your spine, hollow out the tummy, arms float back and up, big inhale, reach up, exhale, fold, half lift, stepping back, chaturanga, up dog. Swan dive, chair, hollow, sweep back and up, and arms come back down to the reach for the floor. quiet the mind. Find your calm in the chaos. Breathe. Take some big, deep breaths. Deep breaths are like little love notes to your body. Inhale, lengthen up. Step your right leg back. Finding a nice high lunge. Back heel stays lifted. Arms are long, shoulders are dropped back into those pockets. Your front knee should be in line with about your third toe. And I want you to try to spread the ends of your mat away from each other. Sink down a little bit lower. Spiral your back heel down. So your front heel is in line with the arch of your back foot, but your hips stay square to the front of your mat. Arms come down parallel to the floor. Wrap your left arm around your right for eagle arms. Lift your elbows off your chest and lean back. Coming up tall, warrior two. Roll those shoulders up, back, and down. Creating space through the center of your body, lengthening. Strong arms, sink those hips. Encourage this knee to stay open so it's in line with your third toe. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, sink back down. Over your front fingertips, palm up, lean back, reversed arched warrior. If it doesn't bother your neck, gaze past your fingertips. If it does bother your neck, just gaze out straight in front of you. Back to warrior two. Watch that knee, I just caught mine creeping forward. Reach forward and grab that left wrist. Lengthen through the front leg. Draw your elbow up into your side. Stack your hand over your foot. Sink your hips. Right arm reaches up. Nice. This is a variation of right angle. You can always bring your hand down to the floor or even down to a block. Lengthen through your front leg, finding triangle. Lifting your ribs towards the ceiling, reaching for the ceiling rather than sinking for the floor, keeping your head in line with your foot, hips are open, chest is open. Revolve closed, finding pyramid. Feel free to adjust your pyramid as needed. I like to step my back foot in a little bit. That front heel still in line with the arch of your back foot. Send your left hip back and draw your right hip through. So if you placed your hands on your hip bones, they would be square to the mat. Soften your front knee and step into your forward fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive. And step the left leg back. High lunge to start. Shoulder blades back and down, sink. Back leg is long, draw that kneecap up into your thigh. Spiral the back heel down. Arms come parallel to the floor. And wrap the right arm around the left. Eagle arms, and lean back. Warrior two. Shoulders back and down. Arms are long. Keeping that knee in line with your third toe. Inhale, rise. Exhale, sink.
Gaze over those front fingertips, palm up. Reverse arch warrior. Warrior two. Left hand grabs the right wrist. Sky arch. Warrior two. Draw your elbow up into your side. Sink your hips. Again, you can stay here. You can drop that hand. Lengthen through your front leg, triangle. Lift your chest. Head over your foot. Like you're in between two planes of glass. Reaching for the ceiling. Draw your ribs upward. And revolve close to pyramid. Again, adjust as needed. Setting the right hip back, drawing the left hip through. Soften your front knee and step to a forward fold. Hang out here for just a moment. Remember, yoga is not about touching your toes. It's about what you learn on the way down. Stack your spine one vertebrae at a time, using your core to bring yourself up. Chin being the last thing to lift. Very nice. Big inhale, lengthen. Exhale, hands heart center, sink to chair. Bring your feet together, nice narrow chair. Try to draw your sits bones towards your heels, keeping your chest lifted. Those knuckles of your thumbs right at your sternum, pressing your hands together. Inhale, reach up. Come all the way up on the toes. Sink back down, hands heart center. Gently rotate towards the right, keeping those hands right at the center, encouraging your spine to twist. You can't hook the knees, that's okay. Bring it right to the center. Do what works for you. Inhale to the center, exhale to the other side. Inhale, center. Big exhale, inhale, lengthen. Arms come down, big starfish hands. Find your calm in the chaos. Bring those feet out about hip width apart. Reach those fingers, draw your shoulder blades together. Lift through the crown of your head. Find your breath. As you inhale through your nose, feel it travel all the way down to your toes. As you exhale, feel it travel all the way out the crown of your head. Your inhale lifts you towards the sky. Your exhale grounds you in towards the earth. Two more. Big arms sweep up. Exhale, fold. Step back into a downward dog. Take a moment to set this up. You have time. Sink through your heels, lift your tailbone. Back is flat. Press your hands away from you. Spreading your mat's ends away from each other. Right leg sweeps up towards the sky. Sink that left heel. Try to reach as high as you can. step your right leg through into that low lunge. This should feel a little different than when we were in the warm-up. Go ahead and set that back knee down. Bring your hands to the inside of your foot and heel toe as far as feels good for you. Let your hips melt towards the floor. Let your chest rise. Drawing awareness to this inner thigh. Rocking onto the blade edge of your foot. Letting that knee fall out a little bit further. Bring your knee back up. Walk your hands to the left. Crossing over the midline, come to the right. And if you'd like, place your right hand up on your knee and look over that right shoulder. Down to the floor, coming back center. So you can stay up here on your hands if this feels good for you. Or if you'd like, you can come down onto some blocks or even down to your elbows. Being mindful of driving your heel and big toe into the floor on this right foot. More big breaths. Coming up onto your hands. Heel toe your foot back to the center. Tuck your back toes, lift that back leg. And step back into your downward dog. Take a moment here. Notice the difference. Appreciate what your body just did. Extend the left leg. Reach high, sink the right heel, and step through. Settle your back knee down. Bring your hands to the inside of your heel toe out. You want to create the same distance on each side, so always working towards the lesser side. That way you're not creating any imbalances. You're encouraging symmetry and keeping our body just happy with one side and the other. Rock onto the blade edge of your foot, letting that knee fall to the outside. Only as far as feels good for you. If you feel like you have to force it, then don't do it. Listen to your body and honor your body. There's a quote from Tony Robbins, and it's, "Trade your expectations for appreciation, and the world changes instantly." And that goes with our bodies too. Bring your knee back to center. Walk your hands to the right. You can expect your body to move in a certain way, and then be let down by those expectations. Or you can appreciate what your body's doing for you, and your body will respond back to you with love, and it will also respond back with being able to be more flexible or open up more for you. The possibilities are really endless. Walking your hands to the left. Placing your hand up on your knee if you'd like and looking over that shoulder. Bring your hand back down to the mat, back to center. Heel toe your foot in. Tuck the back toes if they're not already. Lift your knee off the floor and find your downward dog. Sink through your heels. through a strong core, lift your spine, not your spine, excuse me, lift your navel into your spine and come forward into a plank without rounding through your shoulders. Strong, strong core. Set your left knee down on the floor and bring that left hand in a little bit. Take your toes out, come to a side plank on the knee. Pulling your hip away from the floor, engaging your obliques. If this feels good here, stay here. If you'd like, take that bottom leg out for a full side plank. Embrace the tremble. The shake is a good thing. Rotate back to plank. Set the right knee down. Bring that right hand in and come to that side kneeling plank. Using your obliques to pull this hip away from the floor. I know it's kind of hard to tell because I have a little bit of a flowy shirt on. If you feel good here, stay here if you'd like. Full side plank. To plank. See, I'm getting in my own head too much. I'm starting to stumble over my words. That's okay. Settle your knees down, hips back, find child's pose. Quiet your mind. Big breaths. Bring your feet around in front of you. You're going to lay down flat on your back. We're going to go into a Shavasana. We're only going to keep it about 2 minutes in length. It's not going to be terribly long. But I want you to use this Shavasana to shut out the rest of the world. Draw your awareness in towards yourself. Scan over your body. Quiet your mind. Keep yourself calm in all the chaos that's surrounding us. Go ahead and lay back. Arms out by your sides, palms up, toes fall away from each other. In through your nose, out through your mouth. Surrendering your body to the mat. Thank you. left and right. Gently rock side to side, massage that low back. Hands behind your thighs, assisted roll up.
Coming to an easy seated pose. Sitting up nice and tall. Quiet. Big inhale, lengthen up, fill your lungs with oxygen. Big exhale, get rid of all of it. Big exhale. One more big inhale. Bring your hands heart center. Take a big breath for yourself. Take a breath for all the families out there that are struggling right now. Breath for anyone in the world that might need it. And I'm going to leave this with the definition of what namaste means, because I feel like a lot of us go around saying namaste and don't know what it means. So I went ahead and wrote it down today so that I can make sure that I was bringing you the meaning of it. So I'm going to lose my hand so that I can read. My soul honors your soul. I honor the place in you where the entire universe resides. I honor the light, love, truth, beauty, and peace within you, because it is also within me. In sharing these things, we are united, we are the same, and we are one. Sorry I stumbled through that a little bit. It's kind of dark and I wrote super small. So with all that being said, namaste. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Thanks.